Hey guys, Real Doctor Jin here, board certified internal medicine. Thank you for the watching, subscription, and especially the comments. If you have something good for me to review together with you, leave in the comment. Today we are going to watch episode 3. Oh.
You realize that I'm an attending and you're only a resident.
That's right. This shouldn't be the way residents talk to the attending. You will be in trouble. But Dr. Bailey is different. Wow. What happened? That's too crazy. Will be a lot of trauma case in the ER, for sure.
If all goes well, we'll have an early night.
Chief, dead baby bike race started 20 minutes.
Dead baby bike race. Look at the name. Sounds very dangerous game like you see on the beginning. People kick each other while riding bicycles. We'll see how many trauma case we'll have today.
All right, people, dead baby bike race day.
They got prepared.
Okay, people, the rules of trauma. Don't mingle with the ER interns. They don't know their ass from their esophagus.
Did you hear what Dr. Bailey say? They don't know their ass from esophagus. That's very mean. We blame each other sometimes in the clinic from different department, but that's Dr. Bailey.
I'll take that guy.
You'll have to beat me to him first.
Never held a scalpel.
Whoa, this is a punch wound into the belly. Sometimes can punch through the whole belly and causing bleeding inside. Let's see what happened.
Superficial. I mean, it's cool, but it's superficial.
How do you know those things didn't rupture his peritoneum?
Because he's...
Right, Dr. Gray is correct. You don't know before evaluation how deep the punch wound it is.
Well, we can't just pull them out. I mean,
Oh, wicked.
Are you out of your mind?
That's crazy. He didn't know how deep it is and he just pulled it out. Patients sometimes were bleeding to death inside the belly.
Identified John Doe, mid-30s pedestrian, hit by a motorist swerving to avoid a bike. GCS3, pupils fixed and dilated.
GCS3, now you know the GCS? Yeah, basically it's a score evaluating the trauma patient. If it's GCS3, it's either death or very deep coma. Do you still remember? Usually it's between 3 and 15. If you want to know more about GCS, check episode 2. When patients GCS close to 3, the next step, usually they will evaluate for the brain death.
Fixed and dilated, atropine given for a pulse.
Atropine is a very common medication in saving patients. Sometimes patient's heart rate goes down very low, like 30s, 20s, then give the atropine. It will help the heart rate. But at the same time, please remember atropine can also dilate the pupils. Oh, Dr. Shepard is evaluating the pupil.
No, do an EEG confirmatory tests. If he doesn't respond, 6 hours.
So after checking the pupils, Dr. Shepard wants to do a EEG for the patient. What does that mean? That means Dr. Shepard wants to do the brain death protocol. But you may ask, oh, patient's heart beating and still breathing, why death? So there is special death we call the brain death. That means the brain function totally lost. And EEG is a part of the evaluation, also the confirmatory test, which means apnea test. They will remove the ventilation from the patient and let patient to breathing by himself. If patient have some spontaneous breathing, patient is not brain dead. Patient still have some function from the brain stem. To declare a brain death, usually you need 2 independent physicians to do that. Uh-oh, Easy and Young is very disappointed because they're not going to the OR. What? He's smoking in the hospital.
No smoking!
Right, in the hospital you can't smoke. I've never seen a patient smoking in a hospital. That's why I'm also surprised, like O'Malley. So no smoking in the hospital.
Sweetheart, I've been at the top of the list for 8 months.
Oh, seems this patient is waiting for the liver transplant. And usually the most common situation for the liver transplant is cirrhosis. And for cirrhosis, there are a lot of risks, like hepatitis B and C, drink a lot of alcohol, make fatty liver, also have some congenital disease like hemochromatosis, too much iron in the liver. Usually we can't change much for the congenital same situation. Can we do something to prevent the cirrhosis? Of course, we can do hepatitis B vaccine to prevent hepatitis B, and we can quit drinking to prevent the fatty liver. Dr. Yang is checking the corneal reflexes using the Q-tip. Whenever you touch the cornea, the eye should close. That's the corneal reflexes. As Easy said, we do have some medical miracles because human is very complicated. For a patient with GCS score 3, the chance is about 4% to have a satisfactory result.
People do wake up. That's why we do a series of tests over a set number of hours. So when we call time of death, we know that we've done everything in our power to make sure it's actually.
That's right. Time of death. We try our best.
There isn't going to be any miracles.
We always give patients more chance clinically, but sometimes we need to accept the bad news.
Be a waste of organs.
Oh, Dr. Yang is so smart. She's already thinking about the organ donation.
Take it for some tests. Run a CT. You could have internal bleeding.
No, thank you. I've got a race to get back to.
For this kind of punch wound patient, we do need a CT scan to see if any inside bleeding. If that is the case, sometimes patient can be passed out without knowing there is a huge bleeding inside.
No, thank you. I've got a race to get back to.
Oh, but this patient refused. Then what to do if patient refuses to do it?
Okay, well, you realize you're leaving up against medical advice, then.
Yeah, so patient always have the right to make decision for their body if they are alert, awake. In this kind of situation, the doctors will explain to the patient all the risks for leaving the hospital and then hand them the paper we called Against Medical Advice, AMA form, to be signed.
Okay, well, you have to sign an AMA form.
Right, AMA form.
So why are you wasting time on this? You know how many patients we have downstairs?
If he dies, and he could still live, you know, his death should mean something.
And you want a harvest surgery.
Okay, I want a harvest surgery.
Getting organs from a John Doe is a...
It seems Dr. Bailey is reading Dr. Yang's brain. That is true clinically because Dr. Bailey goes through this internship as well. She knows what intern wants.
Then get consent.
We can harvest the organs.
If you find a family.
So they need to find a family, get the consent for the organ donation.
I have a few hours before we have to declare them, and I'd really like to find this family.
You want their permission for organ donation?
The experienced nurses always know what intern wants and can read their mind too.
I have kind eyes.
Dr. O'Malley is checking the liver size, but usually the size can be easily checked with a CT scan or the MRI. More accurate. Oh, seems patient situation worsening.
For now, had a radiologist look at his chest film. He has a traumatic aortic injury. It's going to rupture and bleed out. So I need surgery if he's going to remain a viable organ donor, yeah.
Do you still remember the widening mediastinum in the beginning? That means the aortic getting bigger. Now the aortic seems ruptured. That's why patient's situation is worse.
So I'm going to help find the family. You guys find a way to get him into surgery.
That sounds a little bit crazy. They are going to do a surgery on a brain death patient. What's the point?
How close a match for the liver is your guy to our John Doe?
Very. Same type, same size. You know, couldn't find a better match.
Oh, seems the organ donor and the VIP patient, the type matches.
We found macular liver.
Dr. O'Malley talked to the chief directly. That's very brave, Dr. O'Malley. Oh, Dr. Burke is repairing the aortic.
Flawless.
Oh, they find the wife.
But if there's still no change, we'd like to talk to you about organ donation.
Will the wife agree for the organ donation?
That beautiful boy may have found you a liver.
Dr. O'Malley find him the liver, approved by the chief. And by the way, look at the eyes, yellowish. It's very accurate. The liver cirrhosis patient, they always have jaundice.
Your husband's major organs, heart, lungs, liver, and kidneys.
Mrs. Davidson signed the consent for the organ donation. That means liver transplant is coming. The belly trauma patient is coming back.
How long has he been waiting?
I don't know.
Viper. Viper?
Oh, he looks very uncomfortable.
Viper.
Wow. It's a huge hematoma there.
Call up to the OR and tell them we're coming and page Dr. Bailey. Right, Alex, let's go. Move faster, damn it! Well, this is a new one. Somebody get her off my patient. Meredith, go get cleaned up from scrubbing. Alex, get back.
That is a huge hematoma. If patient don't get any surgery, he may bleed to death. Patient definitely need a CT scan early before discharged. So different team come to harvest the different organs. Kidney. That's the liver. This is inaccurate. They put the liver right above the eyes. That will cause a lot of damage to this liver. And to preserve this liver, usually you need a special solution. The most popular one is University of Wisconsin solution to flush the vessels inside the liver to preserve the liver. The size of the liver is not that accurate. It's a little bit smaller than the real one. The last organ to harvest is the heart.
But Viper's gonna make it. He's gonna live.
Thumbs up, Gray. She caught Viper in the waiting room. If she missed the chance, Viper may bleed to death, does not have any chance to survive. Okay, now Viper survives. How about our liver transplant patient? Let's see. Oh, he wake up.
Very smoothly.
Happy ending. This is the end of the third episode. I learned a lot about liver transplant. How about you? In this episode, the organ transplant is amazing. Someone's unfortune turns out to be more people's fortune. The VIP patient survives the liver cirrhosis. The donor's cornea will help two patients to gain the sight back. The two kidney will help two more patients to pee. And the heart will save someone's lives. That's another way of living. If you like my review, click subscribe, leave a comment. More episodes coming!